Hey there everyone, back again with another video, and in this video we're gonna move forward in our Flipkart series, or I should say that we should move forward in our beginner series for Flutter. If you are a beginner in Flutter, then this whole series will be very useful for you all, because in this I'm gonna explain each and every step, or you can say that each and every important thing that a beginner should know in order to create your application. Okay, and in the whole series I will be creating multiple things. Okay, and I'm gonna create the whole fully working version of the Flutter, okay, sorry, Flipkart app. So just be till the end of the whole series. It might contain 10 to 12 episodes. I don't know how many episodes will it go, but it will go. So just be till the end, and you, I am sure that you will definitely learn something in the series. Okay, I will show you all the CRUD operations that we have in our application. Okay, so firstly, this is the boilerplate that we have in our application. So firstly, let me show you what it is. You can just run the emulator, let the emulator run. Okay, it is, while it's running, let me show you the basic things. Let me explain you some of the basic things. Okay, in the whole application, basically this void main, we all know that if you are from a C++, C background or a Java background, then you will know that the main function is a thing that is the starting point of the application. Similarly, this main function is the starting point of our application. Okay, and you can see that it has a run app thing in the in the body of this main function. Basically this thing, this run app, let me just show you what this run app says. Okay, let us just go to the declaration of this. Let go. Yeah, it is opening. So you can see that it contains a widget. Okay, it contains a widget. The run app will contain the widget of your application. The binding dot dart, you can just read all these things. Don't think that is too much necessary for a beginner to understand, but still this will take a widget and will move forward with the thing. Okay, so basically, if you are in a in a Java world or a C++ world, then you know about the extend keyword. Basically, it extends some of the property from a class. Okay, so you can see that there are two classes. Okay, one is a stateless widget. Okay, and one is a stateful widget. Basically, these two are the things in which we can create our application. If you have a application that is going to be static, okay, you don't want your things to change on a button click or any of the events, then just go with the stateless widget. If you want to go with the state, that say you can want to have some input and then you have to play around with that, then just go with the stateful widget. Okay, this boilerplate is containing a stateful widget because in that app we have a button on which we click on that app, on the button, the number changes. So if we want to change a thing in this current screen, then that screen should be a stateful widget. Okay, so firstly let us go in this stateless widget and see what it is. Okay, will it open up? Yeah, you can see that, come on, let it open. Okay, so you can see that it is a stateless widget which again extends a widget. Okay, so it means that widget is a super class or the parent of something. Okay, and if you can see that below this, let me just read around that into free. Okay, if you just read some of things, you will understand that they have said that the things cannot be changed because it is interdependent of the context. I'm not able to get that. Okay, leave it, and let us just go to this stateful widget. Okay, let me just open this up. Okay, so you can see that it is again calling the stateful widget, again calling the widget, and inside this it has all the other properties that it should have. And if you see that it has some setter or set state functionalities. Okay, so these all things will be explained in the tutorial. So I think it is taking a little bit of time. Okay, so my system is, emulator is not starting, so let it run start. And the whole series will be an uncut series. Okay, I'm not gonna cut any of these part. If the emulator is running and it is taking some time, I will let it run. So you have to be patient while this whole series goes on. So just have your snacks, or if you are seeing this whole series in a one go, then just have your snacks, because I will be explaining each and every thing in more detail than expected. Okay, so basically I will be explaining all the UI stuff. Okay, I'm not gonna explain that what this class is doing or what this keyword is doing. I will just tell you about the that functionality and other stuff, but still I will try to give you the overview, but I will not go in too much deep. That if you are not a beginner, then if you are a beginner, then it will definitely be a, what you can say, mess for you. So I will not go in so much detail for the keywords. Like you can see that there is a constructor in this class. So what this constructor is doing, so for that you have to understand what this stateful widget is doing, and why is this thing is overrided, and what is this state class. Okay, so one more thing, if you are creating a stateful widget, you will definitely have to create a state class. Okay, this state class will definitely contain all those state variables, all your functionality depending upon everything. Okay, so let me just set it a little bit like this so that you can see what we have, and let me open it up. So it is just installing, so let it install. I think yeah, it's now installed. Okay, oh, and if you don't know how we can create emulator, you can directly search on the Google, or Flutter official site have them, so you can just refer them also. Okay, so come on, start. Don't know why it's taking so much time. And yes, so all the links will be in the description below that I will be using. If I get stuck in any of the thing in the application, then I will definitely refer to it on Google, and all those links will be in the description below. If I see some of the YouTube videos, basically I will not be seeing some of the YouTube videos, but other than the video part that I will be making, if I see any of the blogs or any of their stuff, all the link will be in the description below. You can directly go and refer to them. And if you are, and one more thing, if you're new to this channel, just subscribe to the channel, because it gives me motivation to create all the videos that you like. Okay, and I get some of the suggestions, like I should make video in Hindi also. So I will definitely go with this. After this series, I will definitely try to make a video, because the question was that I should make a video on MVVM pattern in Flutter. So I will definitely make that video, and I will try to make that thing in two parts. One will be in Hindi and one will be in English. So just have some patience, wait for some time, and I will definitely, after this whole series, I will make that video. So that's all thing. So I think my application is running, and why it's not showing? Come on. I think my emulator is to some point slow. Okay, so you can see that this is stuff, and if we click on this button, you can see that this number is getting increased. Okay, so let's start with our application. Okay, and showing you each and every step, that will be showing you the login screen also with that splash screen, other stuff. Okay, So firstly, let me just remove all these things. Okay, I will be going from scratch, so let me just remove all this stuff. Okay, and at the starting we have a run app and we have a my app. You can just go with the any of the name, but I'm going with the my app name. Okay, and now what we have, the first thing that we have to create is we have to create a my app. Okay, and just take this in mind, this run app will take stateless widget. Okay, so we have to create a stateless widget. So you can just, if you are using VS Code and if you have the that extension installed, you can just go to that extension and let me show you this Dart language support and Flutter support extension. You can find those things with all the key binding. So for that, just type STL and it will create a stateless widget. Okay, and just give that the name that you have given in this part. Okay, it will create everything for you. Okay, and in this stateless widget, I will create a material app. Okay, basically material app is the thing that will take care of all that routing and theme and other stuff. I'm not going with the theme for right now in this video, but after I will definitely go with that. Okay, so firstly, if I go with that home, okay, basically I have to give a home for everything. Okay, so what I will do, I will give it a name as splash screen. Okay, I have to create a splash screen and I will create that later. Okay, I will just go with a debug show checked boat banner as false. What is this? Basically, you can see a red line at that corner. It is written as debug. So I don't want this line in my application. So I'm checking it as false. If you want it to be in a debug mode, you can keep it as true. Okay. And after that, you can just go to the theme. You can just create your own theme and title. I'm giving the title as Flipkart. Okay, and one more thing, you can go with the routes. Okay, routes, basically routes will show you that if you, it will, you will have, we will create 2 to 3 different pages, and in order to go from one page to another page, you can directly go using those routes. Okay, so how we can go with that route, I will show you like this. It, you just have to create the name of that route and then you have to go with that thing. Okay, so currently I'm not doing any of those stuff right now. Firstly, I have to create a splash screen. Okay, so let me create a page splash screen .dart. Okay, and inside this I will create a material app material.dart, and after that I will create a stateful widget. And in this tasteful widget, I will just give the name as splash screen. And okay, and you can see that we have already generated the boilerplate, and I will just remove this whole stuff. And I will say safe area. Basically safe area, what it will do, if you have application, okay, so sometime what happens is that in the new mobiles that we are using, your screen that you are creating go on the notification bar. Okay, sometimes if you are not taking care of the UI UX, then it will go to this thing. If you can see that the debug line is going in that notification bar, and I don't want that. So for that, I have created a safe area. Okay, and it will take a child. It has an attribute that will take a child. And in that child, I will give a scaffold. Basically, scaffold is the whole thing that you see here. Okay, that you see here, all that app bar, body and other stuff. So firstly, we have a, we have a body. Okay, we have a not body, we have a splash screen. So in that splash screen, what we have in that splash screen, we have a body. Okay, let's go with the body. And in this splash screen, we have a Flutter logo, and just below it, we have a progress bar. Okay, so what I will do, I will create a column tag. Okay, I will create a column. Basically, column will do is that it will just all the children or the widget that you will be giving inside this column will be arranged in a column manner. Okay, so firstly I will be giving a logo. So currently I don't have a Flipkart logo, so I am just giving the Flutter logo. Flutter allows you gives you a logo by default. If you don't have any logo, you can directly use their logo. If you have, you can use yours. Okay, and then I will go with the progress indicator. Okay, progress bar. I have to go with the circular progress bar, circular progress indicator. Yeah, okay, and let me just save it, and let's just include the whole thing, splash screen. Okay, and save it. Okay, so you can see that we have a Flutter logo and we have a circular indicator. So let us just align it. So firstly, what I will do, I will just set the cross axis alignment. Just see what happens if I set the cross axis alignment as center. Cross axis alignment as center. Just save it and see. Nothing happened. Okay, and if let me just comment it down, and let us just set the main axis alignment dot center. Save. You can see that by this main axis alignment everything has come to the center. And now by this thing, if I set the cross axis alignment again to center, will it do something? It would not do something, because cross axis alignment is done just by the element. So for this, what we have to do, we have to just align everything in center. So wrapping everything in center will do my work. Come on. Yeah, my everything is now in center. You can directly this bulb, if you click at this bulb, it will show you these things like wrap this with a widget, wrap with a column, container, padding, row and other stuff. Okay, and now what I will be doing, let us just do something like this. And if I go over here, if I set the size as 25, let's see if the Flutter logo grows. No. So will it go with 50? Yeah, it is growing. So one more thing, color. I will go with the colors dot white. This Flutter has many of the colors that you will be using. Most of the color they have provided, so you don't have to go with that RGBA colors or any of that hex code. But if you have some of your colors, you can directly use them. Okay, and in order to give this thing a whole blue color that we have in our Flipkart app, then what I will be doing, I will just go in the scaffold and type background color. Okay, background color. And just I will do colors dot blue. Okay, colors dot blue, and save it. Okay, so you can see that we have our application like this. Okay, so this is the splash screen that we have in our application. Okay, and just after we are asked about the languages and other stuff, and after that we will go to the login page. So currently I'm stopping this video right now, so that you can understand what is splash screen and you can just replicate all this stuff in your application. Okay, so the whole code will be in the description, the GitHub link will be in the description below, so you can just go over there and use that code. And if you have not followed me on GitHub or Instagram or Twitter, just follow me over there. All the links will be in the description below. So that's all for today. Thank you. Have a nice day.